guys, my name is Megan, and today I've got a book review for Fangirl for you. Alright, so I know I'm super late to the game on this book, but this was probably one of the best impulse reads and impulse buys that I've ever had. This was such like an unexpectedly good and unexpectedly amazing read, and it's basically, it's a letter to fandom and fanfiction, and I fell so in love with this, and it just really makes me as a fan that reads fanfiction super, super happy to see it kind of, you know, normalized and to see that other people are out there reading fanfic, and I know there are, but seeing it in an actual, like, book is amazing. Before I get into like the whole like me fangirling over Fangirl, I just want to say I wish that I had been more into contemporary books when this book came out, because I was probably about the same age as Kath is in this book when it came out, and this would have been super helpful because, you know, I was going into college about the same time that she was, and it would have been such an, you know, like a comfort knowing that other people were out there struggling with going to college for the first time and, you know, all that fun stuff. So this book, I'm happy I read it now. I kind of wish that I read it so much sooner because it's just amazing. And you know, it kind of felt like visiting a friend that I hadn't visited with in a while, if that makes any sense. Anyway, Kath in this book, I cannot express how much I love her. She is just amazing, and I love her awkward dorkiness and her complete willingness to wear fandom t-shirts to college classes because, you know, that's what I did. And you know, I really like that this is not your typical family dynamics in this as well. It's just Kath and Ren and their dad, and I really like that, and I loved how strong their bond is, and it felt really sweet when they were together. And you know, even though their dad has a mental illness, that's just kind of normal for them. They don't make a huge deal out of it. Kath and Ren may be twins, but they are completely different people and they deal with things differently, and I really like that that's explored in this. And I really like that their whole family dynamic is just kind of really super tight. And, you know, even when Kath and Rin aren't speaking with each other in this book, they're still wondering what the other is doing. They're still concerned about each other. Anyway, back to Kath. I got off on a tangent there. Kath is probably my favorite character out of this book. I mean, I really love Levi and I love their dad and I love Reagan. So Kath is just like this nerd who is unapologetically nerdy, and she may be quiet and shy, but once you get to know her, she's pretty amazing. And I love that she just exudes this sort of like introvertedness, but she also kind of awkwardly flirts with her roommate's best friend, who may be her boyfriend, but not really. And Levi is just such a sweetheart. And when it comes down to them getting into this relationship together, I love that their relationship comes from reading, and I really love that Kath reads aloud to Levi, and I really like that this doesn't go super into depth in Levi's reading disability, but I have a feeling it might be something like dyslexia or something, but it doesn't go too much into detail. And I really like that Kath doesn't judge him too much for that, and I really love that she takes the time to understand what he needs. Kath will sit and read aloud to Levi when he needs help with things, and I really loved that. It was just so sweet. And you know, there's so much about this book to love, and there are a few places where I was like, what? It's just, this book is really incredible, and I think it's really important for, you know, kids that are going into college to maybe give this a read. This is one of those books that I wish I had picked up sooner. This book was just really, really good. I really love it, and I loved the quirkiness. I loved the weird Midwest specific things that they talked about, and I really enjoyed all the characters, and I loved how accessible this made me feel like fanfiction is to people. And I just really love that it's kind of a love letter to fandom and fandom culture. This book got a full 5 out of 5 stars from me. Have you guys read this book? What were your thoughts? Let me know down below. If you guys like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. If you haven't already, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. You can also the notification button. And if you'd like to follow me on social media, check out the links down below. Alrighty, bye guys!